Welcome back to my channel, and today we are going to be talking about the suits that are coming to our server. So they're return recharge suits, and I'm going to show you with the help of SinKitty. So thank you again to SinKitty for helping me film this video. This is her Twitch information. Be sure to check her out. She does a lot of different streams, including our favorite type of streams, which is pavilion pulling. But yeah, without further ado, I'm just going to show you guys whether each suit that is coming back is worth it or not, because maybe that will help you in terms of figuring out whether you want to spend on this event. So first we have Dream Echo. Dream Echo is our first tier and it's going to be $5. There's not much that I think is very unique or beautiful about this suit. The only thing I do want to comment about, or the only two things I want to comment about, is that in the unposed version, I really like the fact that there is fabric hanging off of her dress, but then it's tied to her ring finger and pinky finger, and I think that it's such a unique and beautiful part of this dress. Another thing actually I just noticed right now is that it actually gives you nail polish. So if you like that, you know, this for $5, it's actually not that bad. And I also really like using the warm fur coat. So there is a posed version of this outfit. And if we go back over here, you can see that the entire dress is the pose, which is always unfortunate. And the only other special part about this outfit is Hardy Song is the posed version with the fur coat, right? But then there's also one thing called Heavenly Voice. And it is the posed version without the fur. So if you like that, you can always try to mix and match with it. But yeah, this outfit, it comes with a completion box that gives you the first pose, which is the pose with the fur coat, and then the second one without the fur coat. So for $5, I think that it's like, it's worth it for the price, but then in my opinion, I don't really like the suit in general, so nah, probably would skip over it. And then next we have Star Fantasy. So Star Fantasy is one of my favorite suits in the game. It's so beautiful and it's so fun to use. Like, every item part of this is so amazing. I love the translucent material that they use, and like, especially with darker skin tones, you can definitely see your skin popping out through underneath. I find myself using a lot of her items in this outfit because everything is just great, especially if you want to make a ruined outfit. So for example, we have Flickering Crystal, beautiful. We have this piece, which is also beautiful because it comes with like a faux leglet piece, and it works so well with the skirt because the skirt has a slit, so then you can also see that part through the skirt. Shoes are also very fun to use. It's like very galaxy chunky boots. And then we have the earrings, which are also fun, and a tattoo item, which is great. So we have the hair, and at first I was in love with the hair, but honestly, it's so hard to use. It's so hard to use because it's like a special type of color. It's like a mix of gray, purple, and blue, and as a result, a lot of our outfits, it probably just wouldn't fit. But through some looking around, I found that the Lost Heart dress from this outfit over here, it kind of matches the color in her hair, but because there are some glowy or sparkly aspects to it, it's just like a total different theme slash material. So that's why it may be harder to use compared to other hairstyles, and it's also really blocky. Another great thing about this outfit is that it comes with two poses, and one of them is for the light skin toned Nikki, and the other one is for the super dark skin toned Nikki. So this is the light skin toned one. I personally don't like using the makeup because she, like, it's just hard to use. She looks like a cat, and as a result, okay, why don't I just show you? Like, it's hard to use it because maybe her eyebrows or maybe like the shape of her face. But if you like this type of makeup, by all means, like, that's your opinion and I definitely respect it. But for me, I just feel like, like, it's kind of hard to use. And lastly, we have her with this makeup. I personally love her pose. Like, I find it so fun. I love how her skin is kind of peeking out from not only the coat, but also her socks. I just find, again, the makeup, like, whether it's the light one or the dark one, it's just super hard to use. There was also some controversy with her skin tone to begin with, because there is some ashy or like gray undertone. That's kind of like weird, because why would you put that there? It just makes her look kind of like an alien. Like, I don't know. It can go both ways. We don't always have to take it so negatively, but if we want to focus on something else, you can also see that she comes with nail polish, and that pink nail polish really pops out from her fingers because of her skin tone, and I don't think it pops out as much if you use her lighter skin tone. So yeah, I think that for $15, it's definitely so worth it to get this outfit. It's literally one of my favorite outfits in the game, especially in the Ruin category. And you can see recently I made something. I think she looks so good. Like, look how good dark skin tones look with this outfit. It's phenomenal. And oh, and I forgot to mention, her foreground and background pieces, oh, These are so fun to use, and they work with literally any type of digital or like pixely or ruined type of outfits you would like to make. Next, we have Void Listener. So Void Listener is over here, and I think that this suit is very, very similar to the one from the Hell event called Fleeting Dream. It's from Garden of Spiral Staircase. This is the one I'm talking about. I think that her makeup is so similar. Like, if you kind of mix and match it, you can see how it's similar but different in a sense where this one, the eyes are a little wonky. Like, maybe you don't think so, but I personally think her eyes are a little weird here, and I prefer this one a little bit more. But I do wish it could be kind of like this one where she has eyeshadows, because this one is kind of plain. Anyways, going back to the Void Listener, I really love her hair because I love the little blue tint to the ends or the tips of her hair. I think that it really adds a pop of color, and it really does complement the other parts of her outfits. Like, there is a cotton candy type of vibe to her, because you can see how in this item it's like little motherboards surrounding her, so it's pretty funny. But on the inside there is a blue tint, and it really matches this blue tint over here. So there is some unity with this outfit, and same with this one. Like, look at Abyss of Obliteration. Part of it is that same light blue, and it really, really does vibe and mesh well with this outfit. There's also this little like weird part, which is like, I guess it's nice, but it's also inconspicuous, so I could do without it. The wings are also fantastic if you wanted to use it, and there is also like this shadow that is casted on the floor, and I like that a lot. If we go back over here, there is a posed version of this suit. The posed version, she is again legs for days. Her legs can go for a mile long, and Love Nikki developers still wouldn't know when to stop drawing it. The whole pose, yet again, is the entire dress, and it also comes with wings, so you couldn't really mix and match the wings. It's kind of disappointing that it's not that versatile, given that it's $40 US. So in terms of worth, I don't think it's worth it. That's why I stopped at the Star Fantasy tier. And yeah, like, I genuinely don't think it's worth it. Like, it would be worth it if they somehow made the arm pose like a different pose, and the leg pose a different pose, or I don't know, like just anything else. But it just doesn't scream worth it to me. And one more thing, you know how I said I really like the hair? I still love it a lot. But without this crown piece over here, she just kind of looks bald. Oh, you know what? She also kind of looks like Yuno from Mirai Nikki. Ooh, that's funny, because this game's called Love Nikki, and then, okay, sorry. In terms of worth, I don't think it's worth it. Anyways, let's move on to our next tier. We have Moon Visitor. So Moon Visitor is our last suit. This is apparently around $75 US. I personally don't think it's worth it, because it's just like any other cloud outfit, and it's kind of messy because of the cloth and fabric. Like, I'm not saying it's not beautiful, because it is beautiful. It's just messy in a sense where I can't layer other items on it because there's just so much going on. So if we were to take everything off, I think that the hair is also just like, it's like a typical cloud hair. The cloak is actually pretty nice because it's kind of see-through. The sword is also kind of nice. I think the only thing that stands out to me the most is the makeup, and unfortunately, like a lot of cloud makeups, there is something in the forehead. Like, I wish that little forehead tattoo was a tattoo item so I can just take it off, because her eyes are just stunning here. They could just eat a man up. But if we go to the pose version, I think this is where she truly stands out to a lot of people in the Starry Corridor. So personally, I don't use Starry Corridor that much, but I know a lot of people do, and when they do, they love using this, because this is the iconic piece over here where you can literally make anything. You can make like a room, you can make a house, you can make a window, you can make a treehouse, you can make anything your mind imagines it to be, and it is huge, and you could definitely just create a whole scenery just with this piece alone. It's so expensive for just this one item if you don't care about the other suits and you want this. But then again, if you like the other three outfits and you also like this as well, I think $75 as a bundle for those four outfits together, it's worth it. And yeah, let me know what your thoughts are in the comments below. So right now you can't buy these items yet. I just wanted to do it in advance so that you would be able to just think about it and mull over it for the next few days. Like, it's gonna come on July 17th to July 20th, and your recharge history will be recorded. So if you only recharged up to Star Fantasy like I did last time, then you would just start there. Like, you don't have to rebuy everything in order to reach the Void Listener or the fourth outfit. So yeah, thank you guys for watching. If you like this type of content, remember to like, comment, and subscribe, and comment below which one is your favorite recharge and if you're going to be participating in this event at all. Again, thanks for staying up until this point, and I'll catch you all later. Bye!